What's up, y'all? Anime Rage here, and it's 9:02 p.m. I'm tired. This probably won't be that long. For this, I'm going to be talking about I'm going to be skipping through to the Alabaster arc. Of course, I'm not going to talk about the whole thing because I'm not a fucking maniac. So, yeah, let me just go to where we left off at, and if you hear any background noise, that's my fan. So, yeah. So, like last time I was talking about, we get recruited by Crocodile, and, you know, he gets us for our talents. Kill for his ability to have nearly pretty much an unlimited army supply of people that he can just create, if not from the undead, from skeletons, because everyone knows people die a lot in the world, so he would technically have an unlimited army of people where he can just dispose of, and not just people, he can have undead animals too. So yeah, and you know, he gets me for my ability to, for my flames, having the ability to burn pretty much anything. And my darkness manipulation, my ability to cause illusions powerful enough to kill somebody. So, yeah. And, you know, he also hires Nico for her ability to read the ancient languages. So, yeah. Let me just start this off. A bit later on in the Alabaster arc, you know, where we all meet the Straw Hat Pirates, and you know, they see us and they're like, "How'd you get on our ship?" And you know, they're just looking at us, and I see Sanji eyeing at Robin, and I'm like, "Bro, what you looking at?" As I point my finger towards his head, and his head start igniting in black flames. And you know, Sanji, he's running around in pain because the flame is really hot. And you know, everyone sees the flame and they're like, "Wait, you're the Black Sun." And yeah, I gave all of us, you know, code names because, you know, Crocodile gave all of us code names. You know, Robin, she's still known as the Miss All Sunday. I'm known as the Black Sun. And Kill, he's known as the Black Death or the Necromancer. Either way. So, yeah. And, you know, we try to offer him an eternal pose to the Namoni, y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about. For those who've seen One Piece, know what the fuck I'm talking about. Don't get mad at me if I can't pronounce something, alright? I'm just basically going off memory here. So, Luffy broke it instead, saying that he's not going to allow us to decide his destination. And the princess, they revealed that, you know, Robin, who allowed her to discover the identity of the Beret Works President Crocodile. So, yeah, I'm going to time skip later on. I'm just going to be jumping around place to place to place, so don't expect this to be, you know, chronologically in order. So, meanwhile, at the officer agents of the Beret Works, you know, meet up with us and Crocodile in the basement of the Rain Diners Casino, owned by Crocodile, of course. And they're told the goal of the Beret Works, you know, their final mission and their respective parts in overthrowing Alabast. You know, they get interrupted by Mr. Three, who tells them that the Straw Hats and the princess have escaped during the time in Little Garden. And, you know, he asked Crocodile for forgiveness, but, you know, he get ate by his sharks. I forgot what the shark's name. But just know he had like a weird banana thing on his head. So, yeah. So the officer agents get their pictures of Vivi, I think that's her name, and the Starhead crew, excluding Sanji, with the help of Bo Kurai abilities, and they're ordered to hunt him down, except Chopper as Crocodile, I believe he was with the Strawheads, or he was the Strawheads' pet. And so Crocodile, I'm gonna time skip a little later, where Luffy fought Crocodile for the first time, and of course, you know, he gets bodied. You know, Crocodile says he'll humor Luffy for 3 minutes, but we'll finish him off after the time's up. You know, Luffy, he gets some good shots in on Crocodile, but discovers that he can't hit Crocodile as he just turns into sand thanks to the devil fruit. Let's see if I can remember the Sananomi. I really hope I'm saying that right. So, yeah, Crocodile also shows off some of his attacks as well. One of them, which dries Luffy's arm out. And Luffy takes water from his small barrel to restore his strength. And, you know, once those 3 minutes were up, Crocodile created the sandstorm to send it off to Bura, where Tutu is, and explains that he was the one who was sending storms there every day. You know, Luffy yells for Crocodile to stop, but, you know, he gets impaled with his hook during their fight. And, you know, when Luffy, showing that he was still alive, Crocodile just left him there to die in the quicksand. And so, yeah, you know, me, Robin, and Kale, we show up there. We save Luffy after Crocodile left. And then we leave Luffy in the hands of Pale. And, you know, we tell Pale that Luffy is responsible for bringing his daughter back. So, yeah, time skip a little bit more later. Crocodile reveals that he is going to blow up the plaza, soon to be the center point of battle, where the massive and powerful bomb. And also reveals his true intentions to find the location of a secret ancient weapon platoon, which is said to be buried in Alabast. Excuse me. So, Koza, I think that's the name. Koza wants to warn the city, but is stopped by Vivi, who states that it will create a panic. And so, yeah, the Royal Army raises the white flag with Koza in front, but he gets shot down by a double agent in the Royal Army, provoking the rebels. You know, the battle starts in the plaza, and Vivi watches as all this is just going down. So, again, Crocodile proceeds to throw Vivi off the palace wall, but she gets saved by Luffy, who came in flying on Pale's back. So, you know, Vivi meets up with the rest of the Straw Hats on the floor of the wall. On the foot of the wall, I mean, and goes to search for the bomb with them and Pale. You know, Luffy flies up at Crocodile, and, you know, me, Kale, and Robin go off with Cobra to the, I forgot what that word is. I'm not going to even try to say it. But just know it's where it's supposed to be review of the location of the platoon. Just know that. Platoon. I don't know why I'm saying tune. There's no two O's. So Luffy, armed with a barrel of water this time, fights Crocodile again. You know, as he finds his weakness and manages to get some good hits in. Crocodile, however, can still dry himself out and stop his attempts of getting wet by trying to blow away the soak Luffy in his barrel. Seeing this, Luffy decides to take in all the water from the barrel, you know, completely filling him up. And so, you know, Crocodile doesn't take Luffy seriously and pays for it when Luffy blasts a water bubble completely soaking Crocodile and hits him with a Gomu Gomu no Bazooka. So, yeah, while the fight is still happening, Robin takes the nails painfully out of Culper's body and cuffs him with her power to force the king of the location of the Platon. Meanwhile, a very angry Crocodile recovers and orders his partner to quickly leave. Soon, the warlord of the sea reveals that his powers affect everything, including the inanimate objects, and proceeds to dry out the entire garden of the royal palace and anything connected to it, forcing Luffy in an attempt to hang on to the walls. You know, fortunately, Crocodile appears, grabbing Luffy by the neck as he attempts to soak the Beret Works leader, but, you know, he missed and is pretty much very thirsty at this point and left to die again. But luckily, the water bubbles that Luffy fired back down on him, rehydrating him, narrowly saving his life. And so, yeah, Luffy goes on the pursuit of Crocodile again. And so, yeah, Robin, me, Kill, we're all confronted by Marines led by, Tashigi? Look, I'm not the One Piece just word specialist out here. Just, no. Having more of a personal, you know, thing against the Marines and then the other pirates. You know, she yelled, "Get out of her way." You know, she demanded to she release Cobra. But, you know, we weren't ready to take orders from someone who worked or take orders from the world government. So, yeah. Tashigi later informed one of her men that, you know, Miss All Sunday was originally known as Nico Robin, who received a bounty of $79 million as a kid because she believed that she was responsible for the sinking of 6 warships. So, yeah, obviously very angry, Robin and Kale, we easily get rid of all the Marine people, and I'm just going to say I kill Tashigi with my flames, just incinerate her body. So, yeah. Hold up. Alright, I'm back. I'm going to time skip a bit later. So, you know, the bombs explosion knocking the soldiers over, they simply get up and continue the battle. So, desperately, Vivi repeatedly yells at them to stop fighting, but her voice was pretty much like a just going through one ear out the other. They couldn't really hear. So, yeah. Meanwhile, me, Kale, and Robin, and King Cobra go into the hidden grave of the kings and find the Palingolfish. I can't say that word to save my life. There are a lot of words in One Piece that I can't say to save my life. But, yeah. For those who know what I'm talking about and seen the Alabaster art, good. Because I'm not the best word person for One Piece, because they have a lot of bizarre words and phrases for things that I just can't say. So, yeah. So, Crocodile soon arrives, but does not get the information he wants from the stone. He turns his back on Robin, and, you know, he tries to kill her, but, you know, that don't go well. And so she tries to kill him, which also doesn't go well. So, you know, Cobra triggers a destruction effect on the grave to keep the secret safe, but Crocodile points out that he can easily escape from this ability on his way out. However, he gets in a fight with Luffy again, with Luffy soaked in blood. The punches that he delivered to Crocodile negate his powers due to blood and also the sand hardening. So, you know, Crocodile more determined than ever now to end this fight, releasing the, what was it called, the golden cover to reveal a poison hook that he had. And Luffy is, we save Luffy from the poison, we give him the antidote, and Luffy grabs Cobra, and I grab Robin, and we carry them out of the grave before the cave. We carry them out before the grave cave in. So, yeah. So, you know, after a while of all that, Luffy pretty much passes out on his ship. And they head out. They leave Alabaste, not knowing that me, Kill, and Robin is on the ship with them. So, yeah. You know, after 3 days of sleep, Luffy and everyone wake up. And, you know, we all of us make ourselves known on the board of the Going Merry before their leave from Alabaste. And, you know, we say that we want to join their ship, and we're pretty much their problem now. And, you know, Luffy accepts our offer and joined the crew. And the Straw Hats continued on their voyage of the Grand Line for the whatever shit they're about to do next. And yeah, I'm just gonna say I'm gonna time skip a bit later. It's been about a good 2 years. Yeah, we're all cool with each other, and I'm just gonna say Nami is dating Kill, because I know he's gonna really enjoy that. He really loves Nami. So yeah, there you go, Kale. There's your Nami shit for you. So, yeah. That's it for the Alabaster part. I think I did a pretty good job of going off the top of my head of summarizing some shit. I'm sorry if there were some things that I couldn't remember and you One Piece experts out there can just say without a problem. But I can't. There are still some arcs in One Piece that I can't remember that I might need to rewatch, but I'm not really in the mood to. So, yeah. I'm in it right there. Leave a like, comment down below, subscribe. Go also subscribe to Killer Kill 360. I think the man's almost at 50, so let's get him to 100. So, yeah, with that being said, I'm out. Peace.